So chapter number two. So chapter number two is about the excess and tables and forms, how to create tables and forms. So firstly, let me give introduction to you all. What is MS Excess? So we are dealing with MS Excess, Microsoft Office Excess. Okay, so what is the utility of having this MS Excess? What is Excess? Excess is a database. What is database? Database, actually it is a combination, or it is composed of records and fields. Now what is this record and what is this field? See, record is a row. Record is a row and field is a column. Record is a row and field is a column. Okay, so together the combination of rows and columns, or we can say fields and records, make a table. You are having a table in front of you. Okay, so we are having different records in it, means the different rows in it, and different columns in it. So columns we are calling as fields, and rows we are calling as records. Okay, so in Excess we are using terms fields and records, we are not using rows and columns. Keep this thing in mind. So this is a table. Okay, so table is the intersection of records and columns. Okay, so we are having multiple records and multiple columns, then we are having a table. Okay, so tables are also known as database. I hope it is clear now. So Excess is all about creation of the database and linking of different tables or databases together. Why we are linking? Because we want to fetch data from them. Fetch data means we want to extract data out of them. Okay, so be very careful. Now I'm explaining something that is not in your book, but that is very basic that you must know. Okay, so a table, there is a basic unit of this table, that is cell, where a row and a column intersects. Like this particular first row is intersecting with this first column. It is this cell. So cell, what is cell? Cell is the smallest individual unit of the table or database, we can say. Okay, so intersection of a row or a record and a field or a column, we can say, gives you a cell. So a table is made up of different cells. I hope it is clear. Okay beta, so next is this is a database. How to create this database? We can create this database in two ways. First we need to click on this view. Okay, there are two views or two methods, we can say, how we can manage, with the help of which we can manage this table. There are two views, data sheet view and the design view. Let me tell you the difference between data sheet view and the design view. What is data sheet? As the name itself is suggesting, the sheet containing the data. So this view is your data sheet view, where you can see the data in the database or the table, right? So what is the design view? Design view will hold the field names and their data types. Let me show it to you. So this is your design view. It will let you know how the table will be designed, what all columns you will be having in your database or table, we can say. So you can see very clearly that in data sheet we were having these columns: student ID, name, dance, timings, and field one. Okay, so these are the different columns. Okay, and we are having different rows. Okay, these are different fields and these are different records. How to select a field? Field is a column, right? If I want to select all the entries of this field, then I need to click it on the field header. This is a field header. Heading of the field is field header. This is a field header. This is a field header. So by clicking on the field headers, we can select a particular field. Okay, if I want to select a particular row or records, then I need to click on the row header. So these are the row headers. This is a particular element of this record, but row header is the starting part of that particular, that is highlighted with a different color. Okay, just by clicking on this row headers, I can select a particular record. So I hope that is clear. Selecting a data in the table, so selecting a field, how you will select a field? Click on this field header, so complete field will be selected. And if you want to select a record, then click on this row headers, they will select one complete record for you. Okay, selecting a cell. Cell means a particular data. A cell is an intersection of row and column. Okay, so any particular cell you want to select, you just need to go there. And most importantly at the left topmost corner. Okay, when this plus sign appears, you can select any of the cell just by clicking. When this plus sign appears, that particular cell will get selected. Okay, so you can see pointer changes to plus sign. Okay, next is your using and find and replace option. So what is this find and replace option and how it is helpful for us and why do we need it? So beta, this find and replace option will help you to find a particular entry in the database. Fine. So you can use the shortcut key to find and replace. So find is control plus F. Okay, find is control plus F. So if I am clicking on control plus F, you can see a dialog box will open up. Control F as we press, this dialog box will open up. Okay, so it will give me find. See, whatever cell was highlighted or cell was selected, that particular field will be data of that particular cell will be here. Okay, see, like let us say I want to find Bharatanatyam, how many times it has been used in this particular table. So I'll be just clicking it on and then I'll be clicking on control F. Okay, so I'll be clicking first the cell. So firstly click on the cell. How to select a cell? For that, this type of plus sign I must have. Okay, once this sign, this cell has been selected, then I'll click on control F. Okay, this find and replace option will come now. So you can see whatever cell I had selected, it is automatically appeared in the find what option. So I just want to find how many times Bharatanatyam has come in this particular table. Okay, so I just want key current field. I just want to see in the current document how many times it has appeared and match it from the any part of the field. Any part of the field, what it means ki, let me take another example, then it will be much more clear. Like let us not select anything. Control F again I am doing. So now I want to search RA only. Okay, so in the current document, not in the current field. Field is the particular column. Okay, I want to search it from the whole document and then match it as a whole word or any part of the field or start of the field. So I will go with the option any part of the field, means anywhere it is appearing. Like you can see RA is appearing in Rahul also, RA is appearing in Ranjan also, in Ram also, in Ramanand also, in Ramesh also. So when I'll be searching it, so it will show me. I just want to search all. Okay, so if I am clicking on match case, I have written in small RA, it will find small RA option. But if I am not clicking on this match case option, it will not show that capital RA. Let me click on find next. So it will show me all options. So you can see RA is appearing here also, next RA here, next RA in Ram, next RA in Rahul, next RA in Ramanand, then Ramesh, and so on. Bharatanatyam mein RA is there. So it has shown me all RA present. So let us now click on match case. So where small RA is there, that options only will be shown. Now this capital RA option will not be shown. So find RA. You see RA, this one is not highlighted. Why? Because it is in capital case. Okay, it is not matching with what I have given here. Okay, so this is what find option is. Now find and replace. See, if I want to go with replace option, so control plus H. Okay, now this replace option will also be there. Earlier only find options was there, now replace is also there. So now I want to replace this RA with capital, small RA with, I just want to replace it with capital RA. Okay, so now what I'll be doing, find and replace. So find, you can see it has started finding wherever you feel it is coming. Okay, so it will highlight. So if I click on match, uncheck it, so what you will see, this RA will be shown, capital wala RA will also be shown. Earlier it has not been shown. Okay, now this, because we have unchecked this match case, means do not match the case, just see the words. capital A is R A is also valid, small r a is also valid. Okay, so what I now want to do, I want to replace all the small r a's with capital R A's. Means now check case has also been unchecked, so everywhere wherever R A is there, it this all will get replaced. So just by clicking on replace all, you can see now wherever R A was written, it has been replaced by capital R and capital A. Here also you can see. So wherever R A was written, you can see everywhere it has been replaced with capital R A. I hope it is clear to you. Find and replace option, match case is also there. Okay, so match, search, okay, everything I have told you. Now next is replace option that I have also told you. Control plus H, shortcut key. Okay, otherwise also it is available in home tab. When you will click it here, so it will show you. Actually the screen has not been maximized, otherwise it would have been in front of you. This is your find option. Okay, nearby here only you will get the replace option also in this particular. Okay, so now replace with replace all, everything I have told you. Now changing the table views, I have shown two views are there, data sheet view and the design view. Okay, data sheet view is to write the data. I have already written this data inside this particular table. Okay, so this table is having the data. Okay, so this is my data sheet view, and design view is basically to set the properties related to that data. Okay, so actually whatever field names you have taken will be appearing here. Initially when we are starting a table, we need to create it. Okay, let me take a new database for you and let me show that. Okay, later I will show you brother. Chalo abhi kar dete hain if it has opened. Okay, so now initially you will not be having any data in it. Okay, so when we need to decide the field names, we will go in view and we will go in design view. Okay, if so it is asking me to give the name of a table, let it be like table one only. So if you want to change the name of the field one, so as I have given student underscore id. Okay, so data type means the type of data it is going to hold for you. Okay, so it is saying auto number. Auto number means automatically the data will get entered in this field. You are not supposed to enter it, and it will start from 1, 2, 3 and every time it will go. Okay, so this is, there are different data types for it. If you want to store data like this text you have written, so you need to go with short text. So what is difference between short text and long text? Short text will give you a size of only 255 characters. Okay, let me take another field that is name. Okay, and for that data type you need to select, I will take short text. You can see the field size of this particular name field is 255, means maximum 255 characters you can store in this name. If you want to store more than that data, 255 characters is zyada, if you want to store the data, then you need to change the data type long text. If you want to store numbers in that particular field, you can select numbers. If you want to store date and time, if you want to store currency, if you want to store yes and no option. Okay, so different data types are there. You can select the data type according to your choice. Okay, so next field if I want to say is like marks. So marks will be in which type of data? In numbers. So I can select data type as numbers. So in this way we can create a table structure with the data types, and you can write the description about it, like marks, which term marks are there, UT marks are there, class test marks are, description I can write, but the description will not be visible to anyone until unless he or she is not there in the design view. So this description will be visible in design view only. Okay, so once I'll go back in the data sheet view, it will ask whether you want to save it. I'll say yes. So now you can see that table structure is ready, these three fields are ready. Now I can enter data inside it. Okay, so the data type was auto number, so it will not allow me to enter any data. You can see it is not allowing me, it is giving sounds again and again that you cannot enter. So I just need to go with other, you can see by default it has shown me one here. Okay, auto number means a number by default will be entered into this particular field. So marks I'll be entering 45. Okay, then enter I'll be pressing. So there again it will not allow me to enter any data. I just need to go with the name. Automatically the student ID will have a number. And if I want to change this data, so what I can do, I can take the data type of student ID as number, not as auto number. Okay, so this is this value I have entered,